up, guys? So we're back here at ABC Garage, and we're gonna be tearing the motor and trans out of this Volvo behind me today. I need to get it all down, stripped out and apart, so that I can get the block into the machine shop. I've been talking to a guy out of Kentucky that has built some really cool cars and some badass Volvos. So I gotta get this thing out so I can get it stripped down and on the sand. And then I'll be shipping everything out to the machine shop so that I can get everything nice and clean and looking good. So how we're gonna do that today, because it is a junk car, it's just a parts car. So what we're doing is I gotta set it down and move the lift back a little bit. And then I'm gonna drop the entire subframe right out of the car. So it's, you know, we don't really have to worry about keeping the harness or nothing like that. So the benefit of dropping the entire subframe is there's only a few things we really gotta disconnect underneath, such as the drive shaft. We gotta disconnect that. Otherwise, I don't wanna cut it. I'd rather not. We're definitely going for bigger numbers than what I originally anticipated on. So what we're doing here is we're gonna be hopefully around 5 to 550 all-wheel horsepower. Now, I'm gonna end up blowing drive lines apart. It's gonna happen. I found, I don't know if I want to go to a twin disc setup or not. However, we're going to be adding a lot of that stuff in when I pull everything apart out of the other car. After this one is complete, we'll be replacing the clutch and everything in it. We got a lot of custom work, a lot of custom stainless steel work, and everything under the hood will be pretty much all brand new and custom. There's a company that does some cams for these motors, so I got to look into that a little bit more. When I looked into it, I found out that there's really not much I can do with the head on this car. So I can do a five-angle valve job. I can port and polish everything. Just get it to flow a little better. But they don't really make bigger valves for it. The valves is 1 millimeter bigger, and it doesn't pay. The cost of it isn't really worth it. Now, I can go to a hardened valve, but even that, I don't know if I necessarily want to spend the money right now. And I'll have another whole parts motor and head and everything. So if I decide that I need it or I want to do it, we'll do it then. But the valves are, there's 10 per side. So you have 10 exhaust and 10 intake. I don't remember which was which, but one of them was $75 a piece and the other one was $45 a piece. So I don't know if it's really worth it right now. And like I said, worst case scenario, we blow the top end apart. Well, then we'll figure it out then and fix it. We'll be all of probably $8,000 to $10,000 into it by the end of this build. So, or at least the motor part of it. Everything else is gonna be additional, but it'll be well worth it in the long run. So I'm gonna get to it, and we're going to bring you as much content as I can of tearing this apart. So I'm gonna get moving.
Hey, how's it going?
Well, as you can see, I got the motor out of the car here. Right now, we're cleaning up
all the wire harness, hoses, stuff that we all don't need. So cleaning everything up, trying to get this transmission off, get it off the subframe here,
so we can get it on one of our engine stands and actually get the motor opened up and see what's going on inside. And, you know, hopefully it's nothing dramatic. From what I see, it's all good to go, but I also don't have the lower end open yet. So, yeah, we're gonna keep getting all this stuff done here and keep moving along. And if any of you guys need a S60R 6-speed automatic trans, I got one. I'll let you buy it. I like having a man pedal in my car. So, with that being said, I'm gonna keep going so that we can get this stuff done. Because, you know, it's gotta get done. I need my car to go fast. And this is the heart transplant for it. So, we're gonna keep moving. And you guys definitely need to stay tuned. All right, so we got the motor out here and we got it all disconnected off the subframe, got the tranny off, which is kind of a pain. As you can see, it's a little bit of a mess over there right now because it was a lot you have to take off to get that unbolted off of here. So yeah. Now we're gonna be starting to tear this down to get it down to a bare block. And we're gonna inspect everything, make sure everything's good, and send it off to the machine shop. So what I think was happening, and well, I'm pretty sure was happening, in this motor here, when they had this open and put it all back together, I don't know if they had it timed right. So my guess is that they didn't, and they were smacking the valves. Because in each one of these cylinders here, let's see all these marks here. This one has it. Let's see if I can bring my flashlight up here. Dead spider in there, but you know, down in there, down in there, in there. So these marks indicate that it's been smacking the valves. So I'll have to, when I take that to the machine shop, I'll have them inspect everything and make sure it's all good on that head, which it should be, because didn't look like it really did any damage, didn't crack a piston, did nothing, just gouged it. So yeah, we're gonna be tearing this completely apart and getting the rest of the stuff off of it. So it's a little bit of a project. However, by the time it's done, this block should handle up to 700 horse. Not saying the drivetrain will handle 700 horse, but this block should handle up to 700 horse. So I think I'm gonna call it quits for the day. I gotta work in the morning, so next weekend when I come back out here, or sometime this week, I'm going to be stripping the rest of this car. So I'm going to pull off all of the trim on this car. The doors, interior, I'm gonna pull the whole rear subframe. We'll be pulling all of this. So I gotta see if I can find one of these bottom valances, because I like this bottom valance better than I like the one that's on mine. So I'm going to be taking all of this apart, getting everything off of it. About the only thing that is going to stay in this car is probably the dashboard and the front and back window. Otherwise, every single part that I can salvage will be coming off of this, because I'll be putting it on this car, which this car is a little bit of a mess right now. This car is a Colorado clean car, so there's zero rust on it. It's got a few dings and dents, but nothing out of the ordinary. So we got to send it out and have this little spot here fixed. Other than that, we'll be good to go, besides paint. Then we got Johnny's car, Mazda 626. We got a set of aftermarket bumpers upstairs for the body kit that he wants on it. So we got to do that. And these wheels came off of a Cadillac that I had, and they bolted right up. So we got a few things to go through on that, which as soon as I am done with this car on my lift, the parts car, I want to get his on there. We got to do motor mounts. Got to see if we got a vacuum leak, because it idles kind of funny sometimes. So got to do that, see what we got, and then hopefully we'll see about painting. My car will for sure be painted before AutoMotion. So I got a few things I got to do underneath this hood here. Other than that, she'll be ready to go. So in my last video, I believe I had talked about doing polyurethane mounts and torque mounts and everything else. So I figured this was a good chance to show you on why we want to go to polyurethane mounts. So this is a torque mount here. And as you can see, there is no bushing left in this thing. None. So what I want to do is go to all polyurethane, because the rubber just doesn't hold up, and these things are pretty torquey cars. So this is a constant issue with these things. So I'm gonna go to all polyurethane engine mounts, tranny mounts, subframe mounts, everything. Everything in this car will be polyurethane. But yeah, this is why I wanted to show you. You know, I figured it was good to be able to show you guys on why I wanted to do that. So, other than that, we currently got a big mess out here, but we'll get it all cleaned up, and then we'll be ready for some more stuff. So I'll probably end up loading that thing up soon, and maybe taking it and getting the pressure washed off, I think. Maybe, we'll see. I probably won't. I'll probably just have it acid dipped so that it comes out nice and clean. You know, when I get it back, I can either, well, yeah, I should be able to paint it or send it out and have it done, which I'll probably end up just painting it, because, I mean, I don't know. Also, so the guy in Kentucky I've been talking to has showed me a lot on these, and he has a wicked cool Volvo, and he built some wicked cool cars. So I don't know a ton about these cars. I'm learning as I go here. However, these things are, they're fun. They're very fun. These R's are a blast to drive. Yeah, it's a lot of money to make horsepower, but who else has them? I don't want to be like the rest of society and have a WRX or an STI or a Honda Civic. And I'm not bashing those guys, not by any means. I want to stand out in the crowd. I want to be a little bit different. And because when I go to a car show, I don't want to be part of the 50 WRXs or the 50 Honda Civics, or, you know, I want to stand out by myself. And sure, there may be another Volvo or two there, but they're very underrated cars. You know, when people think Volvo, they think, ew, grandma car. That's what's the best part about it. So, anywho, I hope you guys have a wonderful night. Thank you for watching my videos. And I'm going to continue to bring you guys content. This coming weekend, we're going to tear into this thing. And I'm probably going to start sanding down on this car here so that we can get it ready for paint. I got to get some body filler and stuff like that. So in between doing that, I'll be tearing the rest of this car apart. So that way we can have that thing completely off the lift and everything cleaned up and put away. and then the few parts we have, we'll have for sale. So if you know anybody that has one of these cars that needs a door or any of that stuff, hit me up, because I've got it and I don't need it. The only thing I'm keeping right now, as of all this stuff on this thing, as of right now, is I'm keeping the rear subframe and differential. I'm keeping the seats and all the trim work in the trunk lid. So I'll have a lot for sale. So if someone needs it, let me know. You guys have a great night. Later.